Several days ago, we posted the charging compatibility of the brand new 11-inch iPad Pro, which can be up to 35 watts. And today we got the brand new iPad 2022. We'll test its charging compatibility to see if it can be comparable with the iPad Pro. The most critical update of this iPad is the full screen design, which was used in the previous iPad Pro. This time, the iPad adopts a more dynamic color, and what we got is pink. It also switches to the USB-C port. Now, all iPad models adopted USB-C. It's a pity that it only supports the first generation Apple Pencil. You even have to use a USB-C to Apple Pencil adapter to charge it. That's just ridiculous. Except for that, it doesn't adopt a fully laminated display, which is not as good as the Pro and Air. Back to charging, there is a 20W PD charger and woven cable inside the box, just like the Pro. Use the Apple 140W charger to charge this iPad. The power would be around 25W if we didn't do anything. And then we open the benchmark apps. The peak power can be up to almost 29W, then reduced to about 10W because of overheating. Next, we use some other Apple chargers to charge this iPad. Most of the time, the power is around 25 to 26W. The third-party charger's test results are similar to what we expected. The 9V, 12V, and 15V PDLs are supported. The current is about 2A. And the 20W chargers usually maintain 18 to 19W. During the test, some chargers gradually increased from 20W, some immediately reached 28W, and some increased from 10W. But in the end, they were all stable at around 25W. You can pause to see the charging power of every single charger. A 30W charger is pretty enough, because no matter how high the charging power is, the iPad can only support up to 29W. Compared with iPad Air and Pro, the charging power limit is locked at 29W. We guess the A14 chip might require less power than M2. And that's all charging compatibility tests for the latest iPad 2022. The charging power is similar to the iPhone, so you do not need to have an extra charger. If the next generation of iPhone changes to USB-C, you can even use the same cable and charger to charge your phone and tablet. Hope it won't take too long. Okay, that's all for today's video. Please drop a like and check out the relative videos. See you next time. Bye!